Welcome back to Let's Read Judge Dredd. Today's episode is The Cursed Earth, Chapter 8, The Sleeper Awakens! So let's dig into that. In the wild hillbilly country... Well, that's off to a good start, isn't it? In the wild hillbilly territory of Kentucky, a strange vampire has been attacking and draining its victims of their lifeblood. The hillbillies appeal to Judge Dredd for help, and the search leads to the vaults of the ruined Fort Knox, where...
Drunk it! The hillbillies are going to kill the last president of the United States!
In the vault... This be the vampire, you're around a stake right through its black heart. I mean, it's a president of the United States, kind of deserved. Also, basically, this guy's entirely responsible for the atomic war that destroys essentially all of America, except the couple of mega cities that are still left. And the sign on the wall says, here lies President Robert L. Booth, last president of the United States of America, by order of the judges. So yeah, the judges stuffed him down here as punishment. And of course, we've got our hillbillies all crowded around, ready to slam a spike into him. Which, to be fair, is probably a good judgment on his punk ass, but anyway. On the level above, Dredd and Spikes are fighting off the robot trio that guard the president.
You crazy robots! Can't you get it through your heads? We're trying to save the president, too!
Are you really? I don't know if I believe you. I'll have to think about this, let you know. Land at the bottom of the lift shaft.
Okay, that's enough. Take a look at my badge, the shield of the judges. You're meant to obey, not attack me.
Oh shit, we're the worst robots ever. How the fuck did we miss that?
They don't actually say that.
Oh yes, oh dear. I think we have made a boo-boo.
Worst robots ever. I mean, they're up there with Walter. Walter's annoying, but these guys are just stupid.
We are very sorry. If there's any way we can make amends...
Just stop talking! And that triple echo, it's driving me nuts! You're worse than that metal freak I left behind in Mega City 1! Come on, Spikes!
Okay, but I wish I knew what was going on!
You'll find out soon enough, Spikes. I only hope we're in time.
Meanwhile...
Another bash with the mallet, I should do it, Ichabod. That's the only way. Oh, the vampire's waking up! Quick, grab the stake home before the creature destroys us all.
Drunken. They've stopped the cryogenic process. Hold it right there. Shouldn't have done that.
You shouldn't have done that, Judge. The vampire owes us for what it did to our folk. Stand in our way again, and...
Next page.
No, there's been more than enough bloodshed. The man you're about to kill is Robert L. Booth, the last president of the United States.
What?
You want an explanation? Okay, you got it. Now listen. And listen good. We've got to go back 30 years to 2070 when President Bob Booth pressed a button and the atomic wars began. Millions died. And outside the White House...
An end to this smooth Booth! Resign! Resign! We
The judge is genetically... Oh. The judge is genetically chosen to be tough, but fair. The people turn to them in the hour of need. And so, we've come for you, Booth.
Oh, sorry. We've come for you, Booth. Here's the Declaration of Judgment for the crimes against the American people. Your presidency is at an end.
We, the judges, have taken over.
President Booth was...
President Booth was tried before a grand council of judges and found guilty of war crimes.
Oh, good Lord, pardon me.
But...
what shall his sentence be? America is in ruins. He cannot be allowed to live.
But he cannot be allowed to die. He cannot execute. We cannot execute the last president of the United States for some inexplicable reason.
Only the judges could come up with a sentence that was fair. The famous Judgment of Solomon.
Mr. President, we sentence you to 100 years suspended animation. You'll be taken from here to Fort Knox for protection, and there your body frozen and stored in the deepest vault. At Fort Knox, three medic robot pro... Ro-
At Fort Knox, three medic robots specially programmed looked after the president. Year after year, they checked and changed his blood until the day a bomb hit Fort Knox. And only the president and the robots were left alive.
There's no more blood. We must obey our programming. We must search for more.
That's how the legend of the vampire grew in these parts. Robots who were trying to keep their president alive the only way they knew how. Come and meet Snap, Crackle, and Pop.
Oh, God, really?
Dread led them to the floor above.
I'm afraid it's true. We did go around drinking everybody's motion lotion.
Ugh, that sounds creepy.
We'd like to apologize.
So you'd be the one that killed my daughter!
Wait! That won't bring her back, Ichabod. But Snap, Crackle, and Pop can be mended and reprogrammed to work for you. It makes a whole lot more sense.
The judge is right. There's been enough feuding. Well, what happens to the president, Judge?
I know, Judge Dredd. I know I did wrong, but not another 70 years in suspended animation.
Your appeal is heard, Mr. President. You've served a third of your sentence. I now change it to life.
Later, at Ichabod's farm.
Yes, Mr. President, to living. And that's a whole lot tougher, because every day you'll see the mess you made of America as you work alongside the robots, getting your lily-white hands dirty, bringing back life to the cursed Earth.
And I'll be keeping an eye on you, Mr. President.
Snap, Crackle, and Pop got busy. I much prefer this life, digging. I much prefer this life. Digging, putting manure on the land, and making things grow.
As the Land Raider with its vital vaccine on board continued its journey.
So there were no vampires after all, Judge?
Oh yes, Spikes. The hillbillies were right. All along, a man like President Booth, who caused the blood of millions to be spilt, he's a vampire who puts even Count Dracula in the shade.
Next program, the Slay Raiders.
I hope you'll join us then. Thanks for watching.